Unacademy. Let's crack it.
Hi everyone and welcome to the Unacademy platform. Well, today I have the honor of having a very essential student with me. And why do I call her essential? Because this is just not like any other interview where I would be asking her about her marks and about her preparation strategy, but certainly an interview which is inspiring on a lot of levels for each one of us. So first and foremost, I want to welcome you, Dr. Shah Gupta, on the platform.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Welcome and congratulations, first and foremost. So I want you yourself to tell the students, you know, which attempt was it in the FMG exam and what was your score?
Hello, everyone. I'm Shah Gupta Jabin. I studied from Avicenna Tajik State Medical University and it was my first attempt and I scored 185 marks.
Wow, first attempt, 185. So I'm sure you have like a, you know, a certain preparation strategy that you followed, which all of us are going to come to definitely. And just to begin with, I know all of us from day one of your MBBS, you know that this is ultimately the exam that will get you the degree. This is the final exit exam. So you somewhere yes, know ma'am. From day one that you have to study, but that feeling someone, you know, you keep postponing things and you there comes a time when you finally realize that, you know, this time I'm going to sit for the exam, prepare well. So when was your final last leap of preparation when you just, you know, left everything and you said, ab sirf padhna hai kind of a thing? So when did you seriously get down to study?
I seriously get down to study when I was in fourth year. I when there was pandemic and I thought like let's utilize this time and complete all the 19 subject once. Okay. Read once every like one go reading should be done. And so I completed before going to university back. So I completed all the 19 subject in fourth year only. And after like when I went to university, then I started my first revision from January itself. So from that time, I used to concentrate more on the clinical subject. Like clinical subject should be a base. So if base is strong, so obviously the clinical subject will also be strong. So I concentrate on preclinical subject like anatomy, biochemistry, pathology, micro. So these were like I concentrate more and then I went to clinical subjects.
Okay, so I think the way you said it, your strategy sounds so sorted that, you know, that is an advice that we as educators also always give the students that do not ignore your preclinical subjects. That's actually the foundation. That's the basic. Without understanding those, you cannot straight away jump onto a medicine or a surgery without knowing your anatomy or your physiology well. So I think that must have been something that got you that edge over the others. And you certainly, you know, your score definitely speaks for the amount of sorted preparation that you've done. So roughly you're saying that you finished all, did you depend on some coaching institute or were you listening to videos? How was your first round of 19 subjects like?
I take up subscription of PrepLadder and then Unacademy. Okay. Like teachers like I can understand, I took their subjects more. So I was almost online subjects only.
Right. So online all the videos. Class. So you saw all the videos, you had your notes and 19
yes.
subjects were
yes.
in one place. So
yes.
one source for one subject or did you, you know, for every subject you decided to have multiple sources or different platforms?
One source, one subject.
Right. Another very sorted information given to us. First, preclinicals are a must. Second, one source, one subject. So then you're saying that by one round of your 19 subjects were done, January 2021 is when you started with your revision part of it?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Right.
So I was preparing for a June attempt, but since there was no eligibility, so I could not attempt them that attempt. So I got one more chance to revise again from August.
Okay, fine. So January, when you finally got down to, okay, all your notes were ready, your videos were done. When you got down with your revision, how was your journey after that? Starting from Jan and now that you're saying you gave the exam in December, what was every month like? How did you proceed? What were the challenges and the ups and downs that came in this entire 11-month strategy that you had?
Actually, to be honest, for me, the toughest part of my life was to keep myself motivated and just not get diverted with the situation which was going around me, because it was very much challenging for me. Like we get diverted with the problems which is going on. So I keep myself motivated that I have to achieve this because I work very hard to achieve this, attempt this in first go. So I worked hard and hard, but still there were challenging to keep myself motivated. So I used to watch your videos. Like I watched all your videos, like even the special classes, everything. Like it keeps me motivated. Like if being a teacher, teachers are working so hard for us to pass, then why not we students make our effort, more effort to keep ourselves like give ourselves 100% to achieve this. So it was very much challenging, but still I kept myself calm and motivated to achieve this.
Right, I think very well said, because somewhere the source in the market is the same. I mean, the 19
yes.
subjects are the same, the syllabus is the same, videos are the same everywhere. Motivation is
like
something
everyone,
which all of us go differ from one person to another. So, like you said, in January you started. By when did you finish off like your first revision of all the 19 subjects? Were you able to wrap up well in time?
No, first revision it took time, like it took till March, and then second revision was more like one month. So first
okay.
revision is always it takes time to revise.
Right. So till March, you were done with one revision of all the 19 subjects. So roughly three and a half months, you were over with it. And thereafter,
yes,
what about the rest of the journey going forward? Did you just start off with your second, third revision? Was there any gap?
No.
Was there any lag?
There were gap because there was situation which was not favoring at all. There were problems going on. So I took a gap, and then again, I motivated myself that no, I should not give up, because I never give up on study. I am the person who always keep on working hard to achieve what I dream and what my parents dream. Like I wanted to make them proud, and I hope I made them proud with my marks, but still I will keep on giving myself that how much I can give.
Right. So you said that there was a gap before you started your second revision. So for how long were you not able to get back to studies? And, you know, how did that gap affect your preparation? How did you get back on track? You know, coming back after a gap of a few months or weeks becomes difficult for everyone. You tend to forget a lot of things. So what kept you going in that phase? You know, if you're okay with sharing with us, you know, what were the problems and challenges that you faced exactly? And how did you rise above it and score all of this?
In April, like I lost my mother, but still like there was so much gap, like 2-3 months I took it because I was not able to cope up with my study. Like I was in not in state to study, but still then I thought that I am the elder, so I should work more hard at least to give what she dreamt for me to stand where I usually, so I kept on working hard again and motivated myself.
Right. So I'm really sorry for your loss, Dr. Shagufta. Parental loss is something which probably, you know, it's not something that's ever going to go, and not now, not 10 years from now. It's a void that probably, you know, remains for the rest of your life. But somewhere we do have that thing at the back of our mind, because a lot of responsibilities take over. And like you said, that you were the or you are the eldest in the family. So certainly a lot of responsibility lies on your shoulders, and you were midway through your preparation, so you had to fulfill those. But, you know, really hats off to you, and I give full credit to the strength that you have, because a lot of people do break in such situations. And fighting back and coming back, I mean, it would have been a much easier option to say that, you know, this year I'm not going to attempt, or, you know, this year I'm just going to take a break, or just going to give the exam for the heck of giving it. Because, you know, it's very easy to retort to things like I'm not in the state, which was very understandable also. But you decided to take the tougher path. You decided to take the tougher journey of fighting back with all the emotional turmoil that was going on in your life and in your family. And I think that's I mean, I cannot even express in words, and I cannot even imagine what the different phases would have been. And now I totally understand as to how you say that, you know, keeping yourself motivated was the toughest, because this is something that is at the back of your mind forever. There's not a single day where it would have gone where you would have not thought of that event. So certainly, you know, I totally understand. But how did you manage to do that? What was your strength? What kept you motivated and going? I mean, you must have had days when you did not want to study or you just wanted to leave all the books around you. And on those lows and all those low days, how did you get back on track?
I started more like I'm a spiritual person, so I started reading like Quran, and also it gave me strength in myself that let's give 100% and let's leave everything to God. He will do what is best for me because He has planned the best for every individual. So it keeps me motivating. Like let's every day, whenever I used to get demotivated, I used to read like spiritual books.
I think that is something that certainly shows also, and the kind of calm and composed person that you're coming across also shows that there is definitely an element of spirituality there. So, like you said, that obviously because of all the situation at home, by August is when you finally, could at least get yourself sorted and got back to study. So, starting August, how many revisions did you do up till December 12th?
From August, I made a target like of every subject, like OBG 4 days, like this way I kept all the subjects days wise, and then I divided a part like in the morning I used to attend your kickstart morning classes, and then like my pharma was weak, I could not remember medicines easily, so I gave 1 or 2 med pharmacology, and then the rest of the day I gave to a subject which was was in my timetable, and like 2 hours before going to sleep, like when we are tired from whole day, we don't like to revise, so I used to give 2 questions. So 2 hours I had to give 2 questions, and then another day that goes on like.
Right. So that definitely, breaking it into certain parts always works because you don't get into that monotonous routine of just reading the same thing all day long. What about grand tests? Did you go in for a weekly grand test or once a month? What was your schedule like?
No, I started a grand test with my one of my classmate. Like he was always my support. Like we started together from October. We both used to give same grand test, and I don't know how coincidentally our marks used to like be same,
The same.
like either 1 or 2 or something like this. And whichever test on other platform also we used to give, and it was I don't know how it is same only. And in the exam also which we got result also it is almost same, like
Wow.
I got 185 and he got 181. So like we were I don't know how.
That's amazing. So you are saying by October you started the grand test. So what was the frequency like? How many grand tests did you in total or approximately give?
I gave like 5 to 6 grand tests
And what was your
till
approach to the
last week.
GTs? Were you only reading the explanation of the wrong questions or were you giving an entire day for the analysis?
No, I used to give only like 3 hours, like complete one, and then 3 hours after 3 hours, whenever when the test is finished, that I used to go through all everything, even the right questions and wrong question, but more emphasize on the wrong questions. And if
Correct.
that question is new to me, I used to mark that and write somewhere else that I have to read this topic, like
Correct.
whichever topic I am
Right.
getting wrong more and more. So I used to read,
That
and
is
then when
the
I
ideal approach of a GT where you don't have to focus on exactly how many marks you're getting, but you have to find out which are the topics which you're committing a blunder or committing silly mistakes in again and again, and you have to rectify them. That's like a mock test that you're giving every time and improving yourself. So I think that has definitely worked in your favor. And what about other than grand tests? What about MCQs? How many on a daily basis, or did you go topic wise, or did you have a set target of 50 or 70 questions per day? Anything of that sort?
For me, a test question was more like easy because like after attending tests I used to like questions Q bands everywhere. I used to listen see the topic like this topic is more important, whichever topic is more important, and then when I used to go back to my notes, then I used to go, oh, I missed this topic, so again I used to revise that. So my aim was every day attending more than 100 questions
More than 100
at least.
questions. Wow.
Yes, ma'am.
So I think MCQ practice and usually, students, it's always easier to revise notes. But when we come down to
Yes.
solving MCQs, we somewhere tend to delay the process, or we feel we are not
Yeah.
prepared as of now, and we'll, start this after a month of our preparation. But somewhere
Yeah.
starting with MCQ practice from day one of your preparation is important, because that tells you how to attempt a question. Just having knowledge of notes is not enough. Analyzing it and
Yes.
applying it in a question is equally important. How about images? How much or how did you go with your image revision for all the 19 subjects?
Ma'am, image, like I used to more concentrate on patho and micro. Like these were my like I can say like strong subject at the end. I don't know how, because of you only. I must give credit to you only. Like I used to watch your images decoded 2.0
Yes.
every night before going to sleep. Like I have watched more than two. Radiology to concentrate, like every subject, whichever the images are, like dermatology also images. Whenever there is free time, I used to go to through the images.
Right, I think that's a very useful trick also for the other
Yeah.
students also, that in your break time and when you're a little exhausted from theory and MCQs and all
Yeah.
that cramming up material, then as a break, you get a break also, and at the same time you can revise your images. So images should always be used as fillers between your gaps, between your breaks.
Yes.
Revise the images. So did you like refer to any book, or was it through PDFs and YouTube videos only that were circulated around?
Okay. Ma'am, I used to watch the videos and PDFs more, which were circulated around. And from FMG Solution, there were images of radiology, dermatology. So I did from that.
Okay, well enough. So images, I think in the December exam were not too many in comparison to the June or the previous exams, but nonetheless, images will always be important in one paper or the other, so we cannot escape them. Having said
Yeah.
that, in the end, if I ask you what was your last 30 to 40 day strategy, or the tough part where you're just approaching the exam, did you do a rapid revision of all the 19 subjects, or did you just prioritize and pick up few subjects? If yes, then which ones?
Ma'am, like for everyone, I must say that you should be stay focused and trust your source, and whichever teacher you're following, trust that, because every teacher teaches their way, and it all we should keep revising. That's more important. So I emphasize more on the preclinical subjects: anatomy, biochem, patho, micro. Your base should be strong, so focus on that subject, and then in clinical subject like OBG, surgery, medicine, radiology, dermatology, these we should not leave subjects. So focus on that subject also, and just keep on revising and revising that your source, whichever source you're following, and doing questions also with at
Right,
the same time.
somewhere faith in your source is something which we you that tends to fade away with time. Honestly speaking, with so many students around us mentioning different sources all the time, we tend to doubt our source. That's the first thing we tend to blame, that I don't know this probably because I'm using the wrong source. And I think that is one big mistake that students commit. End moment, changing your source always gets your score down and does not go well in the preparation. So trusting yourself and the source that you selected is of utmost importance. Okay, let's come to the last week, or actually let's come to 2 days before the exam. Anxiety kicking in, panic attacks happening, all of that, tense situation. How did you keep yourself calm? How did you go in that calm state of mind for the exam?
Ma'am, before exam, I used to think that I don't remember anything. Like it's is usual. I think it's happened with everyone. So I thought that I don't remember anything. But at the moment when I kept watching your videos, every videos, whichever was there in the YouTube also, because revising my notes, I thinking that I don't know anything. So I was watching all time like videos last 2 days, and then when I sat on the exam, and it was all remembering. There's nothing that we don't remember. If you have worked hard at that time, you will all remember everything. I have realized this.
Right, I think being blank a week or two before the exam is very natural. And it's also, I always tell students, it's a good sign. If you're feeling blank or if you're feeling that you've forgotten everything, it's because you read so many things that it's human behavior that you'll forget. When you've not read anything, you will feel that you've not forgotten anything. And the fact that you've put so much of information into your brain is the reason that you're feeling blank. So that always is a positive sign, and like you said, students do say that somehow some superpower prevails on that day and sab kuch yaad aa jata hai. So you need to trust the universe that everything will come back to you on that
Come back.
particular day. Like you said, it worked in your case also. What about the duration, or if I talk about the exam day, the duration in between the two exams, the two papers, where students do a lot of chit chat and discussion, what were you doing between the paper one and paper two?
Paper one was a little bit time taking,
Yes.
so I finished 10 minutes before only, and then I got gone through whichever I have marked for review. So I got only 10 minutes, and after in between the exam, like people were all discussing and discussing. I don't know why they were discussing, but I move myself apart, and then in paper two I finished before 60 minutes. Or no, I don't know how. So I got
I
1 hour
probably know how, because you knew so many questions
before.
and your knowledge was so good that you could finish well in time. And I think somewhere what I could, the amount of journey of yours that I know, I can somehow correlate with the fact that you were practicing so many questions. You were practicing 100 plus per day. And that is somewhere showing in the fact that you were able to read through and attempt questions so quickly that you were finishing your paper before time, whereas students who've not been doing that always come back and tell us that, you know, we were falling short of time or we could not read 10 questions altogether. So somewhere you're practicing MCQs in that much of excess on a daily basis has definitely worked in your favor. So all done and dusted. Now you've got a 185. You have a first attempt. And definitely I would say that after such a difficult year for you, your siblings, your entire family, some you know, good news and some ray of hope for all of you. So congratulations to you. Congratulations to everyone in your family. And
Thank
what
you.
here going forward? Where do we see Dr. Shagufta in the future? What are your plans?
I'm now I'll do internship, and then
Right.
I'm planning to do like more. I like my favorite subject for OBG, so I will like to do gynecologist.
Okay, great. So, you know, probably a few years from now, we would be seeing you as a very successful and a famous, you know, obstetrician and a gynecologist. And I think
Thank
I personally don't have a doubt in it, because I can see that potential in you and that dedication to achieve what you've set for yourself. So, any last few words that you want to tell your juniors? It could be anything about, you know, what should they be doing? Should they not be doing? How should they be proceeding? Just last few words for the students appearing for the June 2022 now.
just keep yourself calm and motivated. Don't get distracted by the situation which is going on. It keeps on, like, life is uncertain. We cannot predict a future, but what is in our hand is hard work. So keep on working hard as much as you can, because this is only the time you're giving yourself to more on studies. So give as much as you can, because this will prove at the end. Your result will matter more, because the people will not see the reason behind it. The people will see is the result. So give yourself 100% and leave everything to God. What God has planned for you will be the best for you.
Right. So, also for the students, Dr. Shagufta, I'm sure they have benefited from all the things that you've told us. But personally, I think I have also learned a lot from you. I mean, you're much younger to me, but sometimes, as they say, that Age is not something that determines someone's experience or someone's knowledge, but the amount of motivation, dedication, and so many other things that you have personally taught me today, I think I'm also going to carry it forward and try and imbibe that in myself going forward. So thank you so much. And just before we end, any teachers or educators or anyone else, could be family, friends, anyone whom you want to name, you want to thank, who've been a part of your journey from the beginning. So just anyone whom you wish to say a heartfelt thank you to.
Thank you to, first of all, thanking to you, ma'am. Really, really thank you so much.
From my side, thank you to you for remembering me after your success. For me, that's the most important.
Thank you. And then I would like to thank to Zenobora ma'am. Like her radio also improved my, like I was very much confident in radio images. Like
Definitely.
she's also very good teacher. And like Azam sir in anatomy and all the faculties who helped me. I think every faculty is very good in their way. It's just we have to trust their source, like what they are teaching. And also I want to thank to all my friends who supported me in my tough times, especially all the close one like with whom I used to attend classes, tests like Devesh. He always helped me every time. And also relatives and who prayed for me that I should achieve this at every time, like and all and obviously my parents.
Right. So I'm sure Dr. Shagufta, they are equally happy because somewhere people who are behind the scenes have a greater sacrifice for us than probably we have in our journey. We just keep doing our part, but they are somewhere who are sacrificing much more for us, and that somewhere goes unnoticed most of the times. So I'm glad that you have that support system. So much more strength and power to you going forward. And do keep in touch. We want to see the part two of this video also. And that would be once you crack NEET PG and you get your desired branch, that is OBGY. So I think the story will go on for a second part two of this with Dr. Shagufta. But for the time being, thank you so much, Doc, for joining us and motivating each one of us in whatever experiences you gathered in your journey. So thank you so much once again, and wishing you all the very best for your future, for everything that you do in your future personally, professionally. And I'm sure we have a shining star with us, and with time that's just going to shine brighter and brighter. So thank you, Shagufta,
Thank
so
you,
much.
ma'am.
Thank you. Thanks a lot.